Leopold.
Do you want us to answer all of them?
Huh?
Do you want us to answer all of them?
Yeah,
15.
Because when we answer, it moves us to the next question.
Oh, really?
Oh, okay.
Well, let's do what we work on.
I don't know why I'm not on this.
You can, if you finish, you can move to the next one. But I'm going to go to the same one by one. Because everyone will have their own pace. Still have a lot of students that is choose yet. 8%, 87, 85%.
and B.
A and B.
A and B. What else can be?
Chapter 7.
They're non-obvious. Right? So,
yeah, but
you have to do.
You didn't let me do.
So how many of them there? Just two. Okay.
So the answer is A and B, which are opium, right? Codeine and hydrocodone. Alright, so next one. Seven factors that can cause that. And that is the question.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
no.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Which followings are not antagonists?
CD.
Dr. Zhang, can you speak in your microphone, please?
So this one actually inhibits the degranulation of sensitized mast cells instead of working on histamine itself, so it's not an so what about the other two? What are they? So the deficiency of this one, A1AT, is a known genetic cause of some cases of allergic rhinitis. It's a protease. Its deficiency prevents tissue damage by enzymes of inflammatory cells, such as the neutrophil elastase. Neutrophil elastase breaks down elastin, leading to non-elasticity. A1AT inhibits this process.
D.
C. C.
D.
I thought it was D. Okay, so this is a difficult question. Let me see. Okay, so A? No, Y.
It should be C.
prevents tissue damage, then that's the threat. But it's not the deficiency of this protein that prevents tissue damage. So the answer is D. So this is a little tricky question. So neutrophil elastase breaks down elastin within the long elastin, and A1T inhibits this process. Okay. Corticosteroids decrease the transcription of genes coding for the beta 2 adrenergic receptor and number of anti-inflammatory proteins. Increase the transcription of genes coding for many pro-inflammatory proteins.
Zeloton twist, it is.
Zeloton
two
is.
Zeloton two is.
Zeloton antihistamine.
Why did she put it underneath?
So antihistamine actually works on histamine.
Yeah.
On H1.
In a different way.
Yeah.
Zeloton actually works on this enzyme.
So yeah. So I grouped it with that. Okay.
Mm-hmm. They both belong to
okay.
modifiers, but they function through different mechanisms.
Okay.
Yeah. So the last one is working on
what?
The
organization.
Work on the IgE.
That
you
are to be on the last cell.
So the last cell would not be.
Mm-hmm.
So the answer is A. Do not. Okay. So the answer is C. Which of the following are not SABA? So first of all, what is SABA?
Short acting beta.
Short acting beta.
Yeah, that one is
beta. What is agonist, right? So again, let's take a look. So it's right here.
Yeah,
it's A. Right? It's right here. So the question is asking not. Okay. So first let's see what are SABA. So actually there are two. We only have two listed. Albuterol and levobuterol.
Yes.
So albuterol and levobuterol. So C and D are not the answer, right? Because they are the same.
Yes.
So the other, let's see.
Labo.
Formoterol, what is that? So it's LABA, long acting.
Labo.
Right? Mm-hmm. And bilaterol.
Labo.
Yes.
Labo.
Again, LABA. And the last one, salbuterol.
Labo.
Activation of which receptors can cause smooth muscle contraction?
C.
It's multiple.
You said multiple answers, though.
Yes, multiple answers.
Okay, so this one. Mm-hmm.
Everything
I said everything but A.
Everything
as yes.
Because, well, if we
that's relaxation.
It actually causes relaxation.
Yes.
The one that's marked blue here. Right?
Mm.
So this is the only one that are working on the country compared with other receptors. So muscarinic receptors
yes.
here
yes.
and 3.
Mm-hmm.
And we have cis-MT1 receptor. Here and we have A1 receptor, which is here, okay, and we have H1 receptor, which is that's for histamine.
Slight.
All right. Which receptors do you add adding to the slide?
Yeah, thank you for that one.
C.
Right. So what about A? Which one binds to?
That's the Leukotriene.
Leukotriene modifies to block this.
Mm-hmm.
And H1.
Histamine.
Can block this. Mm-hmm. And then beta 2 adrenergic receptor.
Yeah. Histamine.
And then GQ carbon muscarinic. And it's down here. Mm-hmm. So it's for
acetylcholine.
One is non-selective, the other one is selective.
Yeah, roflumilast is more selective, it's more specific because it's specific to block PDE4, the enzyme is mostly found in the airway. But the silfini blocks PDE, that's ubiquitous, it's everywhere. So it's not only block the
airway,
question.
What's the difference between A and C, like inhibiting and degrading?
So I would say I would also leave A because
that was
this drug does not work on the histamine itself. It actually works on the master cell.
Yes.
It's indirect. Yeah. Maybe I can reword it a little bit. It indirectly inhibits the function of the action of this cell. But directly, it actually whether antihistamine degrades. We know antihistamine can block the action of histamine, but how does it block the histamine? Is it by degrading histamine or other mechanisms? So it's actually block the interaction between this receptor.
So just block.
Not degrading.
So it is
So this question, I think, if this appeared in the exam, I'll probably reword it a little bit, just make it more.
So A means block, is what you're saying?
Monodium sodium does not directly include the action of
It's massive.
So B is actually the mechanism
for chromaline sodium. So if A had mast cells, would that be correct?
The what?
If it said action of mast cells, then would that make it correct? Okay.
If I say inhibit the action of mast cells, then it is a mechanism for chromaline sodium. Okay. Oh, so that's the last one.
Mm-hmm. You have more?
So, no, that's all. We have. So let's see how you guys did.
We don't know.
About post school and pre high school. the exam questions will be similar to those.
How many questions do you have on the exam?
For me, 36.
This was just 15 questions.
You want me to give you the exam
questions?
Yes. All right. And you have a lot of apps.